In this video of 2 meter sessions, Friends Around the World, I talk with Jehnny Beth, actress, musician and producer, and also frontwoman of English rock band Savages. We talk about her first solo record, which is called To Love Is To Live. The album was released in June 2020 and it got a lot of praise from all over the world.
The whole record is about recalling that intensity of living, that density of life, when you're reminded of your immortality and you feel that you're on the edge and you can lose everything and you actually grab on to life a little bit stronger.
We also talk about her amazing music videos.
It was also because I met the director, Anthony Byrne, who's the Peaky Blinders director. He wrote the script for that video and I just played along. I loved it straight away.
And of course, we also talk a bit about Savages.
I really enjoy my time in Savages. I think it's a really a great band. It's very rare to have such a great band.
Hello, Jehnny.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, I'm great, thank you. That's a very impressive stack of records behind you.
It's my library.
Wow, nice. Yeah. Trying to show my vinyls, look, trying to compete.
Oh, that's impressive as well.
How are you doing?
Yes, I'm doing great. How are you?
Not too bad, not too bad.
Where are you actually?
I'm in Paris right now.
All right. Is that your, let's say, normal situation where you live or?
Yeah, I mean, I moved to Paris 3 years ago. I was in London for 12 years before. So yeah, I mean, I wasn't supposed to be in Paris right now. I was supposed to be on tour all around the world.
Yeah.
But, you know, 2020 has decided otherwise.
Well, there's one thing for sure. You've seen Paris in a unique way.
Yeah. It's pretty empty actually at the moment. So it's nice to enjoy Paris in the summer without the tourists, and it's quite interesting and different.
What did you do over the past few months?
When confinement started, it was just before when I started promoting the record. So promo tour was cancelled. A lot of things I couldn't do, and I still haven't been able to do some TVs and, you know, TV shows and to help promote the record, but we'll do them as soon as we can. But I did a lot of interviews online, a lot. And, you know, I did what I could, you know, to promote the record and to talk about it to people.
The album To Love Is To Live is a wonderful conviction. How hard do you find it to?
I just found it's true. You know, to love is to live. And I don't think it's something new. I'm not saying anything new by saying to love is to live, you know what I mean? It's been said a million times in different ways, but I think we tend to forget, and the whole record is about recalling that intensity of living, that density of life, when you're reminded of your immortality and you feel that you're on the edge and you can lose everything and you actually grab on to life a little bit stronger, a little bit more honest with yourself. And it's not really, there's no time for shortcut. There's no time for detours. You know, you need to go straight to the point. For this record, I wanted to start working on the visuals very early on. This is something I discussed a lot with with Johnny Hostile, who produced some of the songs on the record, who's my long-term partner and collaborator. And he started photography when we moved to Paris. So we took a lot of shots and ideas. We were demoing ideas, visual ideas, very early on, the same way you would demo music ideas, basically. For example, for the artwork that we worked on, it came from like a shoot we had done where I covered myself with oil, and there was this idea of a silver skin and transforming the skin and showing muscles. And then, you know, and then it sort of evolved working with Tom Hingston, obviously, and who took it really somewhere else. But it's just all, we have this idea that we have to have a little lab where we're trying and nobody's really looking, and we can try different ideas, everything that comes to our minds.
And I am left with feelings of hatred and violence. Tell me, who am I now? I'm just like you. I'm just like you now.
If you're talking about a video like I'm the Man or Flower, it was also because I met the director, Anthony Byrne, who's the Peaky Blinders director, who chose I'm the Man to feature in the soundtrack of the series. But and then we became friends, and then we talked about doing a video for the song. And to be honest, he wrote the script for that video, and I just played along. I loved it straight away. I love when a collaboration is easy and I don't have to, you know, when someone gets it, it gets it, you know, and I like having other people's in voices into my work.
You look on video as a very outspoken personality. Are you in your mind also very outspoken and there?
If I'm going out and I'm performing something or sharing something or releasing something, it's because I took my time to know what I want to say. So yes, it looks quite formulated and, you know, and together, but that's because I don't want to really go out there and shout if I have nothing to shout about.
What is there to shout about at this very moment in your life?
So much to shout about. I mean, I can't even start to list it. I don't know. I think anger sometimes is a good fuel. I think I just sometimes I'm just very frustrated with the human race and with the violence, and, you know, and I just know that violence exists in me as well, that it's sort of part of who I am and part of who we are as a species. And I feel that's the sort of things that can make me want to break something, you know. A lot of things, I think, it's just being sensitive, which I think is what being an artist is, or that's, you know, I think you just it's not even shouting, like just anger, it's also energy, you know, expressing a certain energy, and that's what we connect with artists. I connect with artists whose charisma and energy is making me want to do things in my life. Yeah. You know, it's sort of an inspirational thing, you know, to see someone express themselves and release some energy and some, yeah. I think that I get that from other artists. So I guess that's what I try to project as well.
Are you a highly sensitive person?
Yeah, I think I am. I think I don't really know how to compare that with other people, but
yeah, of course.
I do feel I think the reason I'm doing this is because I like to feel things as well and try to organize my feelings. Otherwise, it's a bit overwhelming. So, writing a song is a little bit putting an emotion somewhere, and not in a box, but putting it in a place where you're lucky it can exist without harming anybody else, you know, it can just be. I wrote one of the songs of the record called, it's called How Could You, and it's about jealousy. And it was in a way trying to capture that, the violence of that feeling, and put it into a song. And that's sort of cathartic, doing that, because you're structuring your, you're looking at something through different angles, and so you're understanding yourself and the feeling a little bit better, maybe. So it's like anything, it's like doing something, it's an action, you know, writing a song is an action, and the moment you're acting upon something, it just helps, you know. All I want is to go dancing with the devil. All I want is to touch you on every level. I think the art is, well, the writing, and is for me a way to bring things that don't really make sense in life in general and bring them together and sort of give you a sort of a way to try to understand things, and that sort of calms you, makes you a little bit more serene, or, you know, I don't know, more happy.
Yeah.
Trying. I mean, it's never there, but I think it just helps, you know.
Perfect happiness doesn't exist, of course, because we never know when a thing is really perfect.
No.
So the search for perfect happiness is always nice, but you don't want to come there.
Yeah, and I think being happy is not really knowing that you're happy as well. So the moment you realize you're happy, it's sort of, it kills it. Because being happy is being in the moment. I think that's why I love the stage so much, because I feel very much in the moment. There's not really past or future at that point. It's only there and now. So I understand the urgency of life in the distance. There is truth which cuts like a knife. Maybe I will die maybe tomorrow. So I need to say,
is living the way Jehnny Beth does comparable to the way of Savages, the life of Savages?
Yes, it's very different. I think it's very different. Both have their qualities and their difficulties. I really enjoy my time in Savages. I think it's a really a great band. It's very rare to have such a great band. But also because it's rare, it's also perishable, fragile. You know, like anything in life. And I knew I had some desires, musically and lyrically, but I didn't want to stir the band into my own sort of, I think it's very, you know, I had spent several years spending a lot of energy getting, you know, I wasn't the only one doing that, but we were always trying to keep everyone in the same track, and I think we succeeded, because I think the band has its really strong identity, and
yeah.
But that is also a lot of energy, you know, trying to keep that that trajectory. So in a way, I wanted a change of energy. I wanted to spend my energy and focus on myself, maybe, and invest in myself for a while. It may sound selfish, but I think it's just, you know, it was also a matter of surviving and, you know, keeping alive the inspiration. She loves me, yes, I love her. I'm conscious to please her. She loves me, yes, I love her. I'm conscious to please her. And to touch her.
How would you summarize this year, 2020?
Oh, it's an absolute shit year. I don't know. It's terrible. At the moment, I'm writing new lyrics, and I keep writing "I hate 2020" in every lyrics I write. I mean, you know, there are positives into negatives all the time. I just think it's just nobody could anticipate such a collapse. I think some parts of the world are getting, you know, it's rougher in some parts of the world than others, but I still think as a general state of things, it makes you question about the stability, you know, and of different regions and what we can hope for the future. I think still, though, there is real, you know, people are realizing more and more, more aware, I guess, about what's happening. And I don't know. It's hard to be hopeful. Yeah. I just found it hard. I think there are some days where I am, some days where I'm not. The good thing is, like, music, arts and films and are still so important. And to me anyway, I've been reading a lot. I feel I need it for the soul, you know. We still have that, and I feel part, you know, glad I can contribute in my own way.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
And see you soon. Bye.
See you soon.
Bye.
Bye-bye.